7 years ago, when we started Ideas for India, we had a very simple idea in our mind that everyone likes to understand economic issues because they affect our lives. So we thought if we could get research findings of economists and make them accessible to general audience, we'd be doing a service and also perhaps help enhance the quality of public debate. This year, we are entering into a collaboration with Tata Centre for Development at the University of Chicago, because they share our mission of enhancing the quality of public debate through evidence-based arguments.
The IGC is proud to have hosted Ideas for India from the very beginning in 2012. And we're an organization dedicated to taking frontier research into policy. I4I has added an important new dimension in India, which is really to feed this research into public debate, to raise the quality of discourse on some very challenging issues, and to, in that way, feed into policy and build a broader discussion, a broader also mechanism for accountability as these difficult issues are worked through. We're very pleased this evening to be announcing the new partnership with the Tata Center for Development at the University of Chicago. I4I has grown and grown and grown. Over time, it now receives over 25,000 visitors each month, has more than 1,000 contributors, has a new section in Hindi, which we're looking to expand, and has a broader range of topics and important questions that it covers.
I'll just say how excited we are to join in as a partner on I4I. In many respects, it perfectly encapsulates what we aim to do at the Tata Center for Development. And what is it that we aim to do at the Tata Center for Development? It's really, I think, two things. One is to try to understand the world. That's something that we all struggle with, but to use research to understand a very complicated world and make sense of it. And there's little I like more than engaging in debates and trying to understand the world. But I think it's a special opportunity to, you know, it's only wealthy societies that are really able to support people to try to understand the world. And my view is that that's not enough, and that in fact there's a debt or an obligation that universities owe and people who engage in research owe to the rest of the world, which is to share those ideas. And of course, what academics and economists are very good at are developing very precise languages that allow for very efficient communication with each other, but also simultaneously keep everyone else out. So a second and co-equal, if not more important, goal at the Tata Center for Development is to make sure that those ideas and discoveries make it into the broader world. And as with that as a goal, we had looked with great jealousy at I4I for many years and thought, wow, look at what they're doing. They're doing exactly what we want to do, and there eventually came an opportunity to join forces, and I can't adequately express how excited I am about that and look forward to working with the terrific I4I team on many exciting endeavors.
I think the mission of this endeavor is so important in an era when people can have their own facts, and much of public discourse is evidence-free. So the attempt to provide evidence-based information and put it in the public domain is really more important than ever. I wanted to congratulate the International Growth Center and the Tata Center for Development at the University of Chicago for their new collaboration in this joint venture. I think the mission of trying to communicate in plain language is incredibly important. I remember when I first became deputy governor at the Bank of England, a crusty old central banker said to me, "Don't ever let them bamboozle you with fancy finance speak. Ask them questions. Make them be clear about exactly what they're doing, because someone who knows what they're talking about can explain it in clear and simple language. It's those people who don't know what they're talking about who hide behind the facade of jargon."